So traveling again. My loyal driver, Hector, and I were headed to Sacramento today to go pick up a sprinter van that's being built by Todd Ford at Custom Upfits. And we're also gonna pay a visit to our buddies at Works Connection. And then it's on the road again, 2 days later.
So
we're at Custom Upfits, Todd Ford, from the old N-Style Roots days.
Dangerous statement.
How long have you, how long ago did you launch this brand?
Custom Upfits started in 2011.
2011. Specialize in van builds, trailers.
Yeah, I mean, van, moto vans, stuff like that, but also our main business is wheel repair and paint repair vehicles, on-site vehicle restoration stuff.
Cool. There's the Brian Moreau trailer. Thing's super sick. But Todd worked on the Swapmoto Live Sprinter.
Classic this weekend.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey. Are you coming to race the TransAm?
When's that?
This weekend.
Dude, I didn't even know about
you
it.
You could do 1 day only. You don't have to do all two.
All two. Where's it at?
Glen Helen, dude.
Oh. Dude, I don't know. I've been so sick of it. You can hear that I'm kind of sick. I've been so sick over the last week.
Hey, even nowadays when you guys have a normal cold, people are like, oh.
Totally. I don't know if I have a normal cold. I took a COVID test 2 days ago, So I'm waiting for the results.
Oh, well, good thing we had that glass between us.
Yeah, good thing this is the COVID protector.
Is your good bike over here?
My good bike's at my house.
Oh, it's at your house. Got the 500.
It's good and ready.
The 500. When are you going to build that 250 up? The one that I thought was a 125 because the pipe was, or no, those are 125.
That's a 125. So there's my, that's my 500. That's my conversion bike, 252
stroke. Two stroke, yeah.
That's 125. Old 125. Has a 250 pipe line, but it's a 125.
And then this is.
And that there is a 2005 stock KX250.
Oh, this is that one that's super cherry.
Yeah, cherry.
Stock pipe.
Yeah, stock.
And what's and then this 401? Was this Bernard riding that?
Yeah. No. This is a KX120. So I'm going to rebuild. I'm taking these two bikes and I'm going to rebuild one of my 90. I'm going to build a replica of my 90 KX125.
The Mickey Thompson bike.
No, the one I won the first. My first West Coast Supercross. Yeah. On. Yeah. This is my old 600, 650, whatever. And these are a couple loaner bikes that I got.
Nice.
1, 2, 3.
I think there's a 250. Oh, that's my 250 over there.
Yeah, that's yours. Huh. I have one at my house. So I have 1, 2, I have 3. I know Chad has 1, 4. Oh, and mine's the 5th. So yeah, okay, that's all.
Which one is the bike that Bernard Kerr was going to race? Did that go back already?
Yeah, that was a 2019 KX450 that I let him use, one of my loaner shop bikes. And then we gave him the A-kit suspension, which I have, I think, over there.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Nice. I wish that had happened.
I know, right?
Dude, it's taken like a year to get you here.
I know. Well, huh? We were supposed to do it last time I was here.
Yeah.
But it was all the way down to Mexico, basically.
Carl's bad, dude.
Traffic's not fun.
What do you think of the protective glass here?
Well, you learned your lesson. You got in trouble at Supercross. Now you're playing by the rules now.
Ah, dude, come on.
Hey guys, this is gonna take fucking. Okay. Hey guys, I support Brian Moreau. This jersey will be in the custom outfit. What is it?
custom upfits.
Hey guys, I support Brian Moreau and his recovery. This jersey right here will be in the trailer of the custom upfits giveaway.
Steve-o, what was the inspiration for the Shock Therapy Man logo?
Actually, a guy named Scott Wilkinson just drew it one day.
Oh, Wilkie.
Wilkinson.
That might be a self-portrait of Wilkie.
Kind
of
looks like it. Oh, put some glasses on it there, and it looks like him.
So, the Shock is shocking him, right? Yeah. It's a Shock Therapy.
That's exactly what it's supposed to be. Actually, I think it was Don Upton wrote for me back then, and he had his spiky hairdo back then.
Yeah.
And I think that's what Scott kind of made it
out. I'm glad you brought that logo back.
So Moto 2 would be here enough. Get set on the line.
You gotta jump up and down to pack it.
Don't fall for it.
Thanks for coming out.
Yeah, it's fun. It's racing, right?
Heard the track is kind of brutal.
No, it's fun.
Is it?
Yeah, I got
so Dahmer's just soft telling me it's brutal.
Yeah, he needs to go back and eat some pizza.
Yeah.
Hang out a little bit.
I got a pink frosted donut to put on the track and get in the photo with him when he goes out.
Probably scrub the crap out of the jump if that's where it's at.
Yeah. Right?
Did you get some cupping done?
Yeah. Yeah. Come on.
Just jump up twice. See what happens. You know that's going to go slow-mo, right?
Mark Tilley, Dirt Bike Magazine.
What's happening?
Dude, there's a lot of high torquers out here today.
It is. You know what? To be honest with you, I think the best part with this pandemic thing that we're going through and all that stuff, like, nobody knows that we all get along anyway.
Yeah.
Like, everybody in the industry gets along now, so it's not anything crazy. But I mean, I brought my kids out because you guys have the other tracks.
Yeah.
For we're spending the weekend, like, mm-hmm. I have the Dirt Bike Magazine motorhome here and all kinds of stuff. Ron Lawson's here, and it's I mean, you have Kiefer and you have Sleater, and
yeah,
there's
dude, I even saw some of like Jody's test riders out there.
Yeah, I mean, but it's a thing to where nobody realizes that we all get along, and I think in this thing what we've realized is that we all got to support each other.
Yeah.
You guys are having a race, we have motorcycles to race and test.
Yeah.
Let's do it at the same place. I mean, I like racing against, you know, Chris, I like racing against Mike, I like racing against Stapleton.
Mm-hmm.
It's just fun.
Yeah.
Like, so why not come out here and have fun? Yeah, it's a quote unquote another media outlet, but we all want to race our dirt bikes.
We're all trying to grow the same sport.
Exactly. Yeah. And it's, I think that it's really helping.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I've known you for a long time now. Mm-hmm. So it's, if you're doing something, I want to support it. Like, it's not a direct conflict. You're not going off and riding in the trees or something like that. So let's just go have fun.
Yeah.
Let's go have fun. And I've had a blast. And I'm staying all weekend.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to race as many classes as my body will let me. And my kids are going to ride around and have fun. And it's, you know, it's a great time.
Yeah. Dude, how about fighting fit again? Are you back into like 32s?
No, just because I haven't gotten back down. I haven't made my transition, but it's just a thing to where you get older and you gotta, I finally learned how to eat.
Yeah.
Like, so I'm eating stuff like salmon instead of Chick-fil-A or something like that. So it's, you know, and cooking for the kids and stuff like that, it makes riding your dirt bike fun.
Yeah.
And as better. Long as I'm having fun riding my dirt bike and my family's with me, I can't ask for very much more.
Right on. Good luck, buddy.
All right, thank you. Cheers. Pedro.
Donnie, what's
happening? How do the Swapmoto events compare to Orange Helmet Swap Meet? REM.
Well, I don't want to get.
No, we love Frank. We love Frank. I'm just saying.
Yeah, love Frank and Meyer. Been there for those guys forever.
Start, yeah.
But this is fun. I like. Even though it's a long day, I just like the bigger events, and you got more guys on the line to race with, and I don't know. It's just like another like a big event. It's fun to do these things.
Dude, I was telling Tilly. There's a lot of high torque people here.
Yeah.
Like I saw some like orange helmets in the older classes with giant chest protectors.
Oh, yeah.
Those are definitely Jody's guys.
No, there's a whole bunch of those guys out here, which I think is really cool because, you know, 2 years ago, it's like, oh, don't do that. You're bad if you do. Which is ridiculous.
Yeah.
So I'm really happy to see all those guys. And yeah, I know Mark's out here, Ron's out here, and then, a bunch of
test riders and stuff, too. Yeah. So how'd it go for you today?
Pretty good so far. My first 50 moto was horrible. I normally don't get arm pump, but I got horrible arm pump, and I couldn't do anything. So I regrouped. I did my Lee Ramage arm pump thing, and you know what? I've been good.
Nice.
I've been good. So I won the 60, which I should. But I just did my second 50 moto, and I rode. I'm happy with how I rode.
Good.
Nicole won. Chicken got second, and I was on Chicken for a long time, and I was really kind of waiting for him to fade, and I was really kind of disappointed that he didn't.
Right.
But I held my own. I wasn't like spectacular or anything like that. But I rode okay.
Good.
You know. So.
You coming tomorrow?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. We'll see you tomorrow then.
All right.
That's kind of like that's like
that's the mechanic.
Oh, that's the mechanics? Taco Bell, dude.
All those beers, he still beat me.
Hey, you were ripping, buddy.
I felt all right. I appreciate that.
Was that you with the 12,000 RPM start?
Fuck yeah. I want to thank Jim Driver, Pro Circuit, Mitch Payton. That PC mapping and bike is... It's a rocket ship. You seen, he obviously has work done to this thing.
Yeah.
I came out on him. I let him go though because I wanted to hit him and knock him down. I hit him, he just gave me a look of disgust and then he left me.
Hey, I think all the athlete shit has paid off, huh? All this road biking and
I pumped up that last lap.
Wow.
But it's a man's track out there. I need to see what Coors Light Curry's doing this week. Maybe he helped me. He does 50 minute motos.
So how was it? Was there any Clydesdale glory this year?
No.
Oh, you got a podium first moto.
Yeah, Clydesdale, I got fourth overall, so I just missed it. But it was fun. We survived.
Did you ride Clydesdale today?
No. Well, just one plus 45 today.
You didn't ride Clydesdale today because you rode so hard yesterday you lost weight and you didn't meet the weight limit?
Yeah, I drank too many beers last night.
Hey. This is the wrong country flag, isn't it?
Nope.
The worst Mexican I know.
Look at you. Hey, will you take this home for me?
Huh?
Alex said if I can't take it home, I gotta give it back. I don't deserve it.
Oh, because it's second?
Yeah, so I was thinking maybe you could take it home
for me. You want me to take it home? Yeah. I'll get it back to you later. Hey, TV, so how was it, dude? Did the months of training pay off? You look good out there.
The last moto was good. I got the whole shot. Led the whole damn race. Last lap, Mike got me. This dude is becoming just my nemesis.
Cooney.
And I think...
Did he cut the track to get you? Because he's famous for that.
I don't know, but I'll tell you what. We hitting it hard this week. Chick-fil-A tomorrow, and then we're back.
Yeah?
Because... I'm so tired of that one.
A little 100 calorie.
Yeah,
mango.
That's
cutting back from beer.
We're trying.
It is.
Overall, this was such a blast. I had fun. I wish we did like a whole series and like maybe we could do like four of them a year in different states or something, or one in SoCal, one in NorCal. This is cool.
I was fucking impressed with the speed you got back because I remember years ago battling with you at the Industry Cup. You know, I was watching today, I'm like, dude, I couldn't have held a candle to that.
It's coming back slowly, but with Speed, he's just so mad at me.
Because he didn't win? Hey!
If he was, hey! Oh,
whoa, whoa,
if
whoa, I was we dead, got 2 second place guys here. So.
Dead, yeah, he got straight. He got straight worked.
Yeah, but like at least I like tried. You didn't even try. You had a 30 second lead and you just dwindled down. You was just out there. On
oh!
The
just,
I pumped up the last lap.
Well, I don't care.
Hey, what happened to your jersey neck, dude?
I just cut and rip and tear. Trying to get a little bit more comfort, a little bit more air. Summertime, it's getting
ripping
hot.
Ripping in the tearing.
Yeah, that's fine. It works.